Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet the mini bean stitch. Now this also goes by the name of the Elizabeth stitch. The mini bean stitch is a fully reversible, which means it is the same on the front and the back, and has the fantastic bonus of being a one row repeat. To begin, pop a slip knot onto your hook. Now the pattern multiple for the mini bean stitch is 2+1. Now what that means is you're going to chain a multiples of 2, 2, 2 for as wide as you want your project to be, then add one extra chain at the very end. I'm going to be making a small sample today, so I'm going to go ahead and chain 15. Once you have the correct amount of chains, we're going to be working into the third chain from our hook. Now this loop on your hook does not count as anything. You only want to count these fully formed chains hanging down. So 1, 2, 3. And into that third chain, we're going to work our first mini bean. So to work a mini bean stitch, you're going to pop your hook straight into that third chain. Yarn over and pull through a loop. So you'll have two loops on your hook. Then yarn over and go back into that very same chain. Yarn over the back, your yarn should be waiting for you, and draw it through to the front. You should have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all four loops, and then chain one. That is your very first mini bean stitch. Now skip a chain and work a mini bean stitch into the next one. So skip one, insert your hook, yarn over and bring that yarn back through, two loops, yarn over, go back into that very same chain and bring another loop through. You'll have four loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all four loops, and then chain one to secure that little bean stitch. Skip a chain, bean stitch into the next. So insert your hook, yarn over and pull through, two loops, yarn over, go back into that same chain, and draw through another loop. Once you have your four loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through all four loops, and then chain one to secure your little bean down. We're going to keep doing this for the full length of your chains. Skip one, mini bean stitch. Skip one, mini bean stitch. Remember, when you have your four loops on your hook, and you yarn over and draw through, that chain one you do afterwards to lock down the bean stitch, that is all part of the mini bean stitch. Skip a chain, bean. When you get to the very end, you'll have two chains remaining. Work a mini bean into that very last chain. And don't forget to secure it with your chain one. Row two is the pattern repeat row. All that means is you are going to work row two over and over again until your project is the length that you want it to be. So for row two, we're going to chain one and turn. Now we're going to be working our mini beans into the side of the mini beans from the row below. Now if you stretch them a little bit, you'll see there is a little gap in between. Now that is your chain one that secures the mini bean, and this is the top of the mini bean itself. So the part where you yarn over and pull through all four loops, that's this section here. Then you chain one to secure it. Now it's just easier to go into the sort of side and pull it apart. So this gap here is where we're going to work our mini bean stitches. So into this space here, work a mini bean. And chain one to secure it. That's all part of the mini bean stitch, those two little steps. And then move to your next mini bean, pull it apart slightly, and you can see this gap here is where we work it. So you're going underneath the top of the mini bean from the row below, but it's easier to just sort of spot it from the side. So into that gap there, work your mini bean. And keep going along the row. Pull it apart and into that little gap next to it. So you can see it's this section here that you're working into from the row below. So keep going, find the mini bean stitch from the row below, pull it apart slightly, and work your next mini bean into the space, the side space next to it. Once you've done a few rows of this, you will spot that little space without having to pull your work apart, and you get much faster and easier. So keep going, find the little side space of the bean from the row below, and work your new bean. Once you reach the very end one, it's a bit easier to find because it's the last sort of gap. Now you should have the same amount of beans on row two as you did on the very first row. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So to continue, you simply repeat row two. Chain one, turn your work, and work your little mini beans into the side of the mini beans from the row below. Just take a moment to double check you have the right amount of beans and then continue. So you will repeat row two over and over until your project is the length that you want it to be. And then when the project is the length that you want it to be and you have done your very final mini bean stitch, chain one, snip your yarn, leaving a length to weave in afterwards. Pull it up, pull it tight, and it's ready to weave in. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you found it helpful, please do give this video a big thumbs up. And until next time, happy crocheting. Bye.